and welcome to another episode of The Navy Nurse. I'm out and about exploring again with my husband, so I actually just wrote down a couple of things for this video, so I'm going to actually be using a little notepad, so excuse the notepad, but what I'm going to be talking about in this video is what are deployments like for nurses and who gets to deploy while you're in the Navy and what kind of nurses deploy. So I will say, just to start the video off, that I have deployed as a corpsman. I have not deployed as a nurse yet, although when I did deploy, I deployed to Iraq. I deployed on the USS Pearl Harbor on a MEU with the Marine Corps, and then also to Afghanistan. So I do have experience. I can definitely touch on those types of deployments, but I also have a ton of Nurse Corps friends that have done different deployments and where I got my information from. So that way you know where I'm getting the information. Anyway, so what types of deployments are there for nurses? So the first one I'll talk about is the floating hospital ships. There are two floating hospital ships in the Navy. There's the USNS Comfort and there is the USNS Mercy. So when you deploy on one of those ships, it's basically like you are working in a hospital, but it is a floating hospital. And usually those deployments are humanitarian aid type of deployments. So think of going to support the earthquake in Haiti or the hurricane in Puerto Rico. They also do deployments down to South America. They do medical, dental deployments to help those people who are in need of medical and dental help. So that's one type of deployment. Another type is, that's really big right now, is the IA or individual augmentee type of deployments. So right now, you know, technically we're still in a war and we're still having to go to Kandahar. I haven't seen a lot of deployments for nurses that go to Iraq right now. We're all really going to Kandahar still. And there's a NATO Row 3 hospital there. And when you deploy there, it's same thing. You'll be working in a hospital, but it's just definitely a different environment. Before you go, you have to train with either a Marine Corps unit or the Army unit, and you go to learn how to wear gear, how to wear Kevlar, how to wear sappy plates, how to shoot weapons, because when you're in Kandahar, you are going to have to carry around a rifle. I've even seen people carry around nine bells too, so depending on who or where you deploy, you will, you know, carry a 9mm or a rifle if it's in an area that is hostile, like Kandahar. So when you're in Kandahar, you're basically doing the same type of role. Like if you're an ICU nurse, if you're an ER nurse, if you're a med-surg nurse, you're working in a hospital, but it's just the types of patients that you're seeing are different. You know, you're seeing primarily active duty military who are deployed, and you also see local nationals in the area as well. Another type of deployment that nurses do are deployments with Marine Corps units. So I said in one of my earlier videos that you can get stationed in a Marine Corps unit. I was at 1st Medical Battalion in Camp Pendleton, California. So while you're in garrison or in California, you're training with the Marines to basically deploy with them. Types of deployments that you do with the Marines, there are so many. You can go do humanitarian types of deployments. You can go on a MEU or a Marine Expeditionary Unit where you're with the Marine unit, but you're attached to a ship. So the ship is kind of like your taxi cab that takes you to different parts of the world where you do missions. You can also do exercises with different nations, amphibious operations with different nations, and you as a nurse, your work is basically taking care of the Marines and taking care of any of the locals wherever you're at or wherever you happen to be at. Let's see, what else? There are regular types of ships, so not necessarily a hospital ship, but you can be attached to a carrier, you can be attached to a loading dock support ship, and there you're working more like in a clinic type of workspace on the ship. It's not so much a hospital ship. You're seeing more like sick call type of stuff, colds, abdominal pain, but even emergencies, like if there's trauma, if someone's part of a trauma on the ship, then you'll be taking care of those types of injuries. For nurses, you know, at the same time you're an officer, so you'll actually be in charge as well. You'll be leading corpsmen while you're on that ship. Another type of deployment that you can do as a nurse is a fleet, like be with a fleet surgical team. And those, you're attached to a unit and they're in different spots. We have one here in Okinawa. There are fleet surgical teams in California, San Diego area, and also in Portsmouth, Virginia. Those are the only ones that I know. With fleet surgical teams, you are a part of a group that goes to augment the medical personnel on a ship. And what your duty is, or what your mission is to augment that medical team in support of amphibious operations. So you're doing like sea to land, land to sea type of operations. And basically what a good thing to think about is, if you're a nurse, you're basically that medical crew's either leader or a nurse to go and help any medical type of emergency wherever you're at in the world. So those are the biggest types of deployments that you can do as a nurse. There was a question that I was asked. It said, who usually gets sent to go on deployments? Nursing communities who get deployed are the critical care type of nursing communities. So I'm talking your ICU nurses, ER nurses, OR nurses, even the nurse anesthetists. They're super, super deployable. That's not to say if you're a labor and delivery nurse, or if you're a med-surg nurse, or even like a psych, a mental health nurse, that's not to say that you won't deploy. There are different needs in the Navy, and there's always deployments popping up on the tracker. So if you're interested in deploying, talk to your chain of command, talk to the senior nurse executive wherever you're stationed, and ask for those opportunities. I will say, if you're going to be a nurse in the Navy, totally take that. Take the advantage of deploying somewhere. It really, really opens your mind. It increases your skills, and it gives you a cool experience in the Navy. So that's all I have for now. If you have any questions, comments, go ahead and drop them to the bottom of this video. And please continue to like and subscribe. I'll see you later.